Welcome back to the Media 7 Science and Technology Special. Waldo Emerson, who quoth more or less, build a better mousetrap and the world will beat a path to your door. But what if you built a better mouse? Jose Barbosa has the man who hopes that's true too.
G'day, I'm in Christchurch and I'm just trying to... Ah, there you are. Got the bugger. This is a mouse. And they've been our faithful computer friends ever since 1963.
But the basic design has never really changed, until now. This is Grant Odgers. He's a software engineer and inventor who's created a new product designed to take on the big boys.
So this is why we're here. This is the Swiftpoint mouse. It's sort of like a small burlesque couch. And I guess that's kind of the idea, Grant. It's a couch for your fingers.
That's right. In terms of comfort, you could definitely say that.
Grant found it difficult to use laptop touchpads while on the move. So he decided to create a device that would be more comfortable to use while travelling.
If you look at all the mice out there, it's all about getting your whole hand on it and moving it around like this. Whereas we've sort of designed our whole concept around holding it like a pen, you know, using your fingers like this. That means we can make it very small and at the same time very comfortable and very accurate.
It's designed to be used on a laptop surface and has a scroll wheel which can be tilted to move quickly through a page.
Basically, the shape that this device has come out at is really defined by how people have been holding it and all the feedback, not through looking, how can we make it look cool. So if you look at mice that are out there, a lot of them are actually designed in a way to make them look nice without, and then kind of the function side of it is kind of secondary, you know, so we kind of turn that around.
And what about touchscreens? Does that mean we even need pointing devices anymore?
You know, in a desktop environment, if you're using touch, if you're doing this for a significant amount of time with your arms up high and stretched out, you get this thing called gorilla arm where your arms basically just get tired and they feel like falling off. So it's much more comfortable to have your hands rested on the desk for long periods of time. So there's quite a few issues with touch. But having said that, there's some really good applications.
Grant managed to get around $2 million from investors, but we wondered what he thought about the government's commitment to funding innovation.
Being an inventor and an ideas guy, obviously I think the government can do more, could definitely encourage more idea development, getting stuff from idea to product and business, you know, turning it into revenue and export business for New Zealand. If you look at some of the other countries, there's more investment in R&D. It needs private expertise, you know, so it can't be someone sitting in an office going, oh yeah, that's a good one, that's no good. So it would be a partnership. And some of the funds that are there now are designed that way. So they, there's a lot of 50-50 type funds, which I think are a good idea.
Any inventor who's been tenacious enough to see an idea through to launch day should be congratulated. But in Grant's case, that could be extended further because he's employing a crucial idea.
This is the idea that function must precede form, and to my mind, that's a central tenet of good design. What Grant has to do now is convince the public to give the Swiftpoint a crack. That's a really tall order in a world that's enamoured with ugly and useless things.
Well, gents, the guy's not Microsoft, he's not Logitech. Do you think he can do it from New Zealand?
Potentially. He's got some behemoths to take on. But if it works, and it's a fantastic-looking idea, as long as it goes on Mac, I'll have a try.
What's he have to do to get noticed, do you think?
Well, he looks like he's a good communicator. He's got to sell himself to the press, hasn't he?
Would you use one?
I'd love one.
Good.
Are they available?
Yes, we'll put you in touch. Well, thank you very much, Alan Sampson and Phil Smith. After the break, how to read a science story and what scientists really think about the press.